In the Peterson household, we love sports. We love athletics. We love to compete against each other. And of course, we like to watch sports either on TV or in person. Now, there's some disagreement when it comes to the professional level on which are our favorite teams. But when it comes to the college level, we're all on the same page. We love the Liberty Flames. In fact, we get excited when we get to come over to campus and watch the Flames in one of the stadiums here at Liberty University. We put on our Liberty Red to come cheer on our team. In fact, when I come into the parking lot, I see that there are some automobiles that have those flags on their cars with the Liberty Flames logo and the Liberty Red. And they want people to know that as they travel from their house to campus, that they're rooting for their team. And you know, as you and I claim to be believers and followers of Jesus Christ, the reality is you and I are on God's team. We're wearing God's colors. We're wearing God's uniform. And whether you believe it or not, or whether you understand it or not, people are watching you as a Christian, and they're watching you as a believer, and they're watching your behaviors, and they're looking to see whether or not what you do in your life matches up to what you say you believe. They watch you go to church on Sunday. Perhaps maybe you speak out in the community and tell people about your faith. Or maybe you just have one of those fish on the back of your cars, and so they're watching even how you drive to see if your behavior matches what you say you believe. Are you in fact a Christian? Are you a little Christ? And so Paul says in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 1, he says, I urge you as a prisoner of the Lord to live a life that is worthy of the calling that you have received. In other words, you and I should let our reputation precede us. When we go into the community, people should be able to look at our behavior and say, yes, that is a follower of Christ. And so my question for you is, when people say your name, when your name comes up in conversation, what are the thoughts that come to others' mind? What do they think about? If I were to say to you some names like Nero or Hitler or Mussolini, what type of thoughts would come to mind? Probably evil, atrocity against humankind, mankind, right? Not very good thoughts. But if I were to say to you Mother Teresa or someone like Billy Graham, what would you think? Usually good thoughts, people that have contributed to the work of the kingdom, people that have lived a life that is worthy of their calling, that followed after the things of Christ. In Proverbs chapter 22, verse 1, it says, a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches. In other words, it's better for us to have a reputation than the wealth that this world provides. And so my challenge to you is to ask yourself, are you living a life that is worthy of your calling? Are you representing God's team well? Are you wearing the colors loud and proud? And when people see you and they see your behavior, do they say, that is a follower of Jesus Christ? That's somebody that follows after Christ. Paul wrote another letter to a young pastor named Timothy. And in 2 Timothy chapter 4, he speaks of a man named Demas that was working with Paul in ministry. But unfortunately, he tells Timothy that Demas was no longer with him, that he loved the things of this world, and so he'd gone on to Thessalonica. And when I read that passage, I think to myself, if Paul were to write about me, and ask yourself, if Paul were to write about you, and he was writing to Timothy, what are the things that he would say about you? Would he say that you are someone that is living your life that is worthy of the calling that you have received? My prayer is that you and I will be able to do that.